What's up, friends? Welcome back to another video. November is Native American Heritage Month, and I've been participating in Indigathon. I posted my TBR a week ago, so I'll have it linked up above and down below if you would like to go and see what I'll be reading. It was created by Brody and Michelle, and they're doing a great job. There are so many fun things associated with this readathon. There's a bingo board for the reading challenges, there is Instagram challenges, and today I'm going to be doing the video challenge, which is the Indigathon book tag. I was tagged by Audrey over at Perpetual Pages, and I'll have their video linked down below as well as the questions. This tag is all about your Indigenous reading, so this is kind of like an update on my Indigathon, so I'm gonna get right into the video. As always, check my description for updated petitions and donation links. There's a typhoon that is hitting the Philippines, Honduras, and has also hit Vietnam. I'm gonna be having links down below to donate on Twitter. There's been a lot of threads where people are selling books in exchange for donations, so I'll have that all linked down below if you would like to donate. Let's get into the video. For this tag, all of the authors must be Native authors. So the first question is, what is your favorite book? And I have to go with two. First being the last book I read. This random Indigathon, I found my favorite book, and this is Pet by Akwaeke Emezi. This might come as a shock to everyone because I don't read fantasy books at all, but I loved this so much. It was so good. This is about Jam, who is a 15-year-old trans girl and selective mute. She's living in the city of Lucille. Lucille is a perfect world where everyone can exist and be themselves. Essentially, it's a perfect world. There is no crime, there's no racism, there's really nothing that is going wrong that could affect anybody. But one day, Jam goes into her mother's studio and a creature called Pet comes out of one of her mother's paintings. We learn that Pet is there to hunt a monster, but everyone's really confused because all of the monsters are gone. And so we're just kind of figuring out what Pet is and what their mission is. And I thought this was so amazing. The message of monsters as a metaphor was so good. And I think that's like my favorite part of the book. I love that. Akwaeke Emezi is now my new favorite author. I've been sleeping on them. I love them so much, and I will read every work that they've ever written. I loved this book so much, and I highly recommend it. I read this book for the prompt outside of the US because Akwaeke Emezi is Nigerian and they are Igbo. I just had so much fun reading this book, and it takes a lot for me because I don't read fantasy, and I talked about this in my middle grade reading vlog that I was like, oh, I really want to read fantasy, so I guess your boy is a fantasy lover now. The hype is real. I loved this so much, and I would love to reread it. It was hands down one of my favorite books of the year. Catch me recommending this book all the time because it was fantastic. And I have a novella, which is Mapping the Interior by Stephen Graham Jones. I read this in October, and it is about a boy named Junior whose father has passed away. And if you know my channel, you know why I love this book, because grief is one of my favorite tropes. I just love it being talked about in books. And specifically this one, I really enjoyed it because it was about him seeing his father in shadows and like just feeling like someone is following him. I really enjoyed how the author talked about grief in this book because it talks more about the denial stage where Junior thinks that he sees his dad and he's like, oh, he's gonna just become a solid and everything's fine, like trying to convince himself that his father didn't actually die. And this is told from the perspective of Junior in his 40s, and he's telling the story of him being 15. I really enjoyed this. It was really quick, and I enjoyed what I got out of it. And like I said, I love grief. And so if you like grief and you want a short book, I highly recommend this book. The next question is, what book do you recommend to most people? Ever since I read it, I have not shut up about it, and this is the poetry collection Holy Wild by Gwen Benway. This is a poetry collection by a Canadian trans woman who is of Anishinaabe and Métis descent, and this is all about the trans experience, but also the trans experience as a trans Indigenous woman, and I loved it more so because it was very intimate. I love poetry because it's very intimate and personal, and I just love to see how each poet can just make it their own and make it unique. And the way that Gwen made hers very unique was that she added her language. She added Ojibwe language into her poems, and I love loved that. This made the whole poetry collection so personal and just brought it together, and I loved it so much. It is very triggering, so I'll have the trigger warnings down below. There's a lot that goes into this poetry collection, but I loved it so much, and I am always going to be recommending it. I have really gotten into poetry this year, and it is because of Indigenous poets, and this is my favorite one. I also just read Disintegrate, Dissociate by Arielle Twist, which is another poetry collection by an Indigenous trans woman, and I love that one as well, so I would recommend that if you've already read Holy Wild or vice versa. Loved both of those. I think they're great. The next question is, what book did you pick up because of a recommendation? Obviously, I picked up Pet. Everyone has been talking about this. Specifically, I know of it from Brody and from Jesse at Bowties and Books. And like I said, I loved it, so their recommendation was very good. But I also have a book that I read for Readathon, and this is From the Ashes by Jesse Thistle. I found this on a Canadian blog that was recommending nonfiction by Indigenous Canadian authors, and I really enjoyed this. This one also has very heavy content. This book is a recollection of Jesse's childhood to his mid-20s, and it is all about resilience. He grew up in poverty, he was stealing all the time, and he did get into hard drugs. This one was really hard to read. I listened to it on audio and I really enjoyed that. I think just listening to nonfiction books, especially told by the author, just makes it more intimate, and I really liked what I read from this. I don't really like to rate nonfiction books, especially that have like hard topics, because I don't think I should really rate his life. So I did not give it a rating, but I did really enjoy it. And I always feel weird saying that I enjoyed it, because I don't enjoy reading about his hardships. It was very hard to read, but I do think it was important to read. I really like reading about resilience, and this was a great nonfiction that did tell the story of resilience from childhood to his mid-20s. And it also talks about how he didn't know much about being Native and he was embarrassed of it. And I really enjoyed the resilience of that and like the development of him getting more in touch with being Native. He is Métis Cree, and like I said, he's from Canada, so I did get to hear about the Canadian experience, but he did go through a lot, and I will have the trigger warnings down below too, because there's a lot that goes on in this book. Like I said, it was a really hard read, but it was a really great recommendation. I really enjoyed it. The next question I already answered, but this is, what was your most recent read? And this was the poetry collection Disintegrate, Dissociate by Arielle Twist. Like I said, this is a poetry collection from a Canadian trans woman, and I got this recommendation from Kayla at Books and Lala when she was reading this for her readathon, and I wanted to get to it for this readathon because I like to read poetry, and I really enjoyed this. I felt the same as I did from Holy Wild. I just felt like it was very intimate, very personal. There were some really great lines in this. It made me cry. All of these poetry collections just make me cry. Just from like the first poem, you just caught me crying. It was really great. I really enjoyed it. And the author definitely put all of her emotions into these poems. Next question is, what is your next read? And this one I'm really conflicted on. I am currently reading There There by Tommy Orange, but I have two more books left on my TBR. I have Mongrels by Stephen Graham Jones and Cattywampus by Ash Van Otterloo. I have Mongrels on Hoopla, and obviously I have this physical copy from the library. So I think it's just gonna be depending on which one I have to return first is what I'll read. But I think I am gonna read Mongrels. And like I said, with Mapping the Interior, I really enjoyed Stephen Graham Jones and his writing and just his work. So I do want to read some of his work. And this is the November pick for the Spooky Bitches Book Club run by Brody and Angel. So I do want to prioritize that as well so I can read it with everyone and talk about it. So we'll see what happens. I don't know. I've been updating my reading on Twitter and Instagram, so definitely follow me there if you haven't, if you would like to see some live updates. And the last question is, what 2020 release do you want to read before the end of the year? And I have two for this. First being A Lat's Away by Darcy Little Badger, which I'm probably going to be reading for the Queer Lit Readathon. I'll have my TBR up next week for that. And I want to get to Night of the Mannequins by Stephen Graham Jones. This just sounds so cool. The premise sounds awesome. It is a horror book about mannequins coming to life, and I love that so much. I'm so excited. I heard it's so scary, and I just need that in my life. I'm so excited for it, and I would love to prioritize reading that one if I can. I've been having a hard time finding this one because Hoopla doesn't have it. I'm gonna have to recheck my library, but I hope by the end of the year I get to read this book. If not, I'll just transfer it over to my 2021 TBR because I've already got that started. In my mind, 2020 is over, so I am all committed to next year. So that's it for today's video. Thank you all for watching. I have a Patreon if you'd like to support me there for only $1. Next month, I'm going to be building a gingerbread house and answering some questions, so if you would like to see more videos like that, go over to my Patreon and become a paperback pal for only $1. And feel free to subscribe if you haven't already. I hope you're all having a great day and staying safe, and I will see you next time. Bye.